Here's a question for you. What makes a house a home? While us humans have spent thousands of years blurring the lines between architecture and interior design, it seems that the animal kingdom has been far more efficient in constructing the places that keep them safe from predators and sheltered from their elements. After all, shelter is the first step to survival. Well, if you've already seen part one of this amazing list, then you'll already know that you're here for some truly amazing structures in the wild. And thankfully for us, there's plenty more where they came from. Here's the 15 most amazing homes built by animal architects, part two. Huge beehives. Alright, for our first entry into this amazing architectural world, don't look down. Because if you've got a fear of heights, this horrifying honey-collecting occupation may be a little difficult to stomach. It's no secret that honeybees make some of the more complex and intricately patterned hives in nature, demonstrating the truly magical mathematical properties of the hexagon. But in some far-flung corners of the planet, honeybees are making hives like no other. Located deep in the beautiful mountainous country of Nepal, the ancient art of honey hunting has resulted in an almost spiritual and cultural appreciation for the enormous hives that the giant Himalayan honeybees produce for their colonies. The only thing is, they're located over 300 feet in the air. As the largest bee on the planet, the Himalayan honeybee prefers to build its enormous honeycombs hanging off the edge of a cliff in order to keep them far away from any prying predators. This isn't just any regular type of honey, though, because up in the mountain abode, these large bees are busy making some of the world's rarest and most cherished honey. Known as mad honey, it's a reddish sweet goop that produces psychotropic effects in small doses, meaning that us humans have developed a pretty sweet tooth for it, shall we say. While the honey hunters in the area risk their life and limb in pursuit of tracking down these incredible hives, they remain to be one of the more extraordinary animal architects on Earth. Hey, hey, did you know that if you smash the like button, subscribe, and click the notification bell, you're more likely to win the lottery? So what are you waiting for? Prairie Dog Towns. From the highest mountain peak to deep beneath the surface of the Grand Prairie, while this next entry may raise a few eyebrows, there's no denying the sheer ingenuity demonstrated by these incredible animals. Prairie dogs aren't exactly known for their extravagance, but it seems that, far away from prying eyes, these cute critters have been perfecting their own style of animal architecture beneath the ground. Known as prairie dog towns, these burrowing networks can be found across the grasslands of North America, assembled in intricate displays that often shelter anywhere between 15 to 16 family groups. As highly social animals, these large underground towns can often span hundreds of acres in a single unit, with many members of a prairie dog family group inhabiting the same territory and coexisting peacefully. Amazingly, the social intricacies of the astonishing homes don't end there, because a prairie dog town may also have deeper subdivisions, known as wards, which are separated beneath the ground by a physical barrier. Essentially, it's like having their own kind of prairie dog neighborhood hidden beneath the dirt. These incredible creatures will spend the vast majority of their lives hidden in these networks of tunnels, and they remain to be some of the more efficient and effective burrowing architects in the animal kingdom. The Narcisse Snake Dens. Uh-oh, if you've got a fear of snakes, then it's probably for the best that you look away for this next entry. And while these serpents weren't exactly responsible for constructing their elaborate winter den, there's no denying that they've made effective use of the space. Think less architect, more interior design. What are we talking about? Well, of course, the Narcisse Snake Dens of Manitoba, Canada, the world's largest single concentration of snakes in the world. Every single year, Canada's Narcisse Snake Dens are the home to tens of thousands of garter snakes that slither their way across the country to seek shelter from the winter, as well as reproduce. En masse. As you may imagine, this strange homecoming is quite a terrifying spectacle, and at one point, the population of garter snakes in the area approached almost 70,000 individual animals. Located in the small Canadian town of Narcisse in Manitoba, the snake dens were formed out of crevices and tunnels that have eroded throughout thousands of years into the porous limestone of the region, creating the perfect hibernation grounds deep beneath the surface. Hey, you can't say they don't make efficient use of the space. During the winter months, after the area has been covered in thick and impenetrable snow, the thousands of snakes will safely hibernate here until the spring. Once they're safely thawed out, they'll get to reproducing, creating a brand new generation of snakes that will one day call this place home as well. Naked mole rat colonies. Okay, if your first thought that the whole ancient snake empire was weird, well, you ain't seen nothing yet. Let us introduce you to one of the strangest creatures on the planet, the naked mole rat, an animal that continues to baffle scientists with its dazzling array of genetic anomalies. But we're not interested in the fact that these animals are technically immortal, because today we're taking a look at the only mammal in existence to live and breed in an insect-like hive, similar to that of bees and ants. Yeah, you heard that right, naked mole rat hives. In the same way that an ant would continue toward its underground society, each naked mole rat colony operates in an almost identical kind of fashion to that of hive-based insects, where each of them has a single queen, with the rest of the colony serving as a hormonally controlled, perfectly engineered, non-producing worker. Yeah, these creatures are mammals, guys. This behavior is genuinely one of a kind, and it's something that has perplexed scientists for decades. Sure, meerkats and prairie dogs may be organized in similar kinds of societies, but none of them live in hive-like colonies quite like those of the naked mole rat. Plus, if that wasn't already weird enough, these mysterious creatures pretty much defy the biological law of aging. They're essentially resistant to cancer, and they can survive up to 18 whole minutes without oxygen. Yeah, we're as confused as you. Spiral beehives. Speaking of strange insect hives, well, we certainly can't make a list on amazing animal architecture without exhibiting one of the more dazzling bug-based installations that we've ever seen. Bees make hives, we all know that, and they're formed around the basis of the amazing mathematical properties of the hexagon, functioning as the most efficient and effective shape in most of the animal kingdom. So then, why is this strange hive of an Australian stingless bee in the shape of a spiral? Well, the short answer is, no one knows. As one of the only stingless bees on Earth, the Australian insect is already somewhat of an enigma, but ever since researchers and beekeeping experts discovered that these amazing critters were forming their homes in strange spiral shapes, it seems that the mystery has only gotten weirder and weirder. What we do know is that this little circular pod that can be observed forming the spiral is known as a brood cell, and within these tailor-made pods, individual bees will grow from egg to adulthood in the span of roughly around 50 days. To build these cells, worker bees in the hive will secrete a wax-based substance from their abdominal glands while mixing it with a plant resin known as cerumen. Once one layer is assembled, the workers will move on to another segment of cells, building them upward and outward in this amazing spiral pattern. Wow! Gigantic Texan spiderwebs. Alright, while naked mole rat colonies and spiralized beehives are one terrifying oddity, this next entry could certainly be mistaken for something out of a horror movie. And unfortunately for a number of Texan locals, that's exactly how things played out when they found themselves trapped inside the largest spider web ever created. Back in 2007, a once-in-a-generation event occurred in a 380-acre forest just outside of Dallas, Texas, that saw a swarm of Guatemalan long-jawed spiders descending on the region to spin the mother of all spider dens. To top things off, the invasive arachnid event also coincided with Labor Day weekend, which is probably the perfect ingredient for a horror movie-style creature feature. Initially, scientists were completely stumped as to what type of spider could have created such a massive web, but once it was revealed that the long-jawed orb weaver was responsible, things started to make a bit more sense. You see, these amazing arachnid architects spin some of the more elaborate webs in the animal kingdom, often covering large areas at any one time. Incredibly, it's thought that millions of tiny spiders had been blown over during a mass dispersal event, and as they caught the air currents with their silken webs, they rolled them to the U.S. mainland in a never-before-documented phenomenon. Obviously, the first thing they did was settle down and spin themselves a new home, and it seemed that this sleepy Texan park was the perfect place. Oregon pipe mud dauber wasp. While we've seen the incredible spiral hives of the Australian stingless bee, as well as the extraordinarily high honeycombs of the giant Himalayan bee, it seems that not all species of flying insect like to do things so elegantly. Feast your eyes on the Oregon Pipe Mud Dauber Wasp, a species of wasp that build themselves weird and wonderful nests out of mud, dirt, debris, and sometimes even their own vomit. Assembled in the shape of some kind of musical instrument, the Oregon Pipe Mud Dauber's nest is created in the shape of a cylindrical tube, or as its name suggests, like an organ pipe, which is a type of pan flute. These strangely efficient structures are built on a wide variety of environments, ranging from the horizontal or vertical faces of bridges, walls, cliffs, or even at the top of skyscraper buildings and apartment blocks. The thing is, things get a little weirder the deeper you delve into this bizarre insect's home. As predatory wasps, the mud dauber's den contains a wide number of rooms, not just to house the eggs, but also to serve as asylums to keep their prisoners. Yeah, you heard that right. These insane insects hunt down creatures such as spiders and bugs, stun them into a paralyzed state so they can't escape, and then trap them in their strange and horrifying hovel. Why? Well, to feed the kids, of course. The Baya Weaver. Alright, let's step away from the terrifying insectoid prisons for a moment and instead take a look at one of the more beautiful bird nests in the wild. Native to both the Indian subcontinent and Southeast Asia, as its name suggests, the Baya Weaver is a weaver bird that builds its home from a series of grass, straw, and other plant debris that they can find. Preferring to inhabit mainly grasslands, this animal will often build its nest near water or even hanging above water, choosing to dangle its elaborate elongated nest high in the air where predators cannot easily reach it. Amazingly, unlike many other weaver birds, this type prefers to nest in colonies of anywhere between 20 to 30 other members of its species, where they can often successfully integrate into female-led societies. Believe it or not, but the male Baya Weaver will always be the one to build and construct the nest, while the female is left to hunt and provide for the colony. Once the nest has been constructed, the female will inspect it and see that it's fit for purpose. If not, she'll wreck it and throw it to the ground. Yikes, talk about harsh criticism. The long-tailed tit. While we're on the subject of incredibly ingenious bird architects, let's take a look at another astonishing example. Take a look at the long-tailed tit, an otherwise tiny bird that demonstrates an unrivaled propensity for design out in the wilderness. As a commonly found bird across most of the United Kingdom, as well as certain portions of Europe, the long-tailed tit constructs its intricate nests out of moss, animal hair, and incredibly, sometimes, feathers of other birds. As highly social creatures, both the male and female will work together when building the nest, often taking up to 3 weeks in order to perfect their architectural craft. Shaped like a bottle, their nest is assembled with a roof and an entrance hole located at the top, where it's then camouflaged with lichen and interwoven cobwebs harvested from spiders. In order to make the inside of their nest cozy, the long-tailed tit will line it with a dazzling array of feathers, often featuring up to 1,500 feathers in a single nest. Talk about being resourceful. Her narrow bird's fortress. Sure, the long-tailed tit was pretty darn incredible, but it seems that there's no stopping these avian engineers. If you thought a nest made of feathers was impressive, then let's take a look at the intricately baked mud huts of the Rufous Hornero, a species of bird native to South America, which may very well be one of the only birds in the world that uses pottery to build its home. Amazingly, the Rufous Hornero create their nests in such an elaborate design that, when they were first recorded by scientists, they were mistaken for being old wood-fired ovens, giving them the nickname the Red Oven Bird. Unlike pretty much any creature on Earth, this astonishing animal engineer is one of the only avians to construct their nest entirely from mud, which is then left out in the sun to bake, forming a primitive type of pottery. During the nesting process, which is usually spread over 2 weeks, these birds will manage to collect around 2,000 individual pellets of mud, which are then assembled into an impressive dome-like structure complete with a curved internal wall, entrance chamber, and fully guarded roof. Without a doubt, it's one of the more astonishing nests in the natural world. The Australian leaf-curling spider. If you thought that Guatemalan long-jawed spider was impressive, then let's introduce you to one of Australia's most ingenious insect engineers, a creature that certainly makes the most of what few resources it can collect. While recycling is often found in the intricacies of the animal kingdom, it seems that the Australian leaf-curling spider takes that sentiment to the next level. Native to the forests and woodlands of eastern Australia, as well as being commonly found in many urban areas, the Australian leaf-curling spider are orb-weaving spiders that protect themselves from predators by enveloping themselves inside a large, curled leaf, which then they seam together with their own highly elastic silk. After hoisting the stray leaf from the ground, the spider will use the silk threads from its legs to curl it into a protective cylinder, where it then seals shut at the top and leaves a small opening at the top, ready to attack anything and everything that comes its way. Incredibly, these spiders have been known to use snail shells as the protective dome. Yeah, it's super effective. Edible nest swiftlet. Alright, while we've seen some incredible entries so far, this next entry is a little more sinister. Sure, these amazing animal engineers may construct some of the more complex and efficient shelters on the planet, but for the edible nest swiftlet, a cruel twist of fate has resulted in them being at the center of one of the more bizarre culinary practices in human history. Endemic to Southeast Asia, the edible nest swiftlet, also known as the white nest swiftlet, is a small bird that assembles its nest entirely out of solidified saliva, making them incredibly lightweight and delicate. Weighing just 15 grams and measuring around 5.5 inches in length, the nests of these animals are precious to the touch, but believe it or not, they're traditionally used in the Chinese and Southeast Asian culinary practice of bird's nest soup, which is made by soaking and steaming the nests in water. Astonishingly, some of the more prized versions of these nests can often fetch up to $3,000 per pound. And so the practice has resulted in the lucrative harvesting of the nests in unbelievable numbers. While it's seen as a delicacy in certain parts of the world, unfortunately, the astonishing nests of the edible nest swiftlet aren't often used for their primary purpose. The ruby-throated hummingbird. Sure, we can all agree that any species of hummingbird is a beautiful and mesmerizing animal, but it seems that the ruby-throated hummingbird is a cut above the rest. And while it's a truly spectacular creature to witness in flight, it seems that the ruby-throated hummingbird also stands out for its astonishing nesting habits. Every spring, the male member of the species will be the first to arrive in the traditional nesting area, where he'll then begin stalking out the site for feeding opportunities. Then, once the females arrive, the male ruby-throated hummingbird will then perform a series of intricate U-shaped diving displays in an effort to convince their counterpart that they're physically adept. Typically, the hummingbird's nest will be engineered almost entirely from spider silk and plant materials. And while that's a pretty rare building material, it actually has an ingenious purpose. Amazingly, the spider silk actually allows the nest to expand as the hatched chick grow, allowing room for their ever-growing bodies throughout their early days. Once the silk-clad shape is finally set, the female will then camouflage the whole thing with lichen and moss, making it camouflage to the rest of the world. Incredible. Compass termites. While we've seen some pretty remarkable bugs so far, few of them can compete with the sheer magnetism of the compass termite. Sure, termites may be considered an unstoppable pest to mainly human engineers and woodworkers, but in the animal kingdom, few creatures are as architecturally impressive as these bulbous critters. In what's become known as one of the most significant insect civilizations on Earth, the compass termite is endemic to Australia's Northern Territory, deep inside the protective Litchfield National Park. Incredibly, assembled in huge earthen pillars, this region is filled with hundreds of enormous termite mounds that are mysteriously aligned with the Earth's magnetic field. Rising as high as 10 feet in the air, these relatively flat vessels all face in the exact same direction, with their thinner edges facing to the north and to the south, almost exactly like the needles of a compass. Currently, scientists believe that these insects build their homes in such a precise manner in order to keep the climate of their colony as temperate as possible. However, that's just a theory, and the truth behind this astonishing engineering is yet to be determined. The diving bell spider. And finally, if you thought that these amazing homes were impressive, what better way to top things off than with the most surprising nomadic spider we've ever seen? Sure, while spiders aren't exactly known for their ability to swim underwater, It seems that this extraordinary creature has taken to turning their own home into a life-preserving aquatic raft. Found in the freshwater ponds and streams of Europe, as well as in parts of northern Asia, the diving bell spider, commonly known as the water spider, is one of the few species of arachnid to live its entire life almost entirely underwater. Amazingly, while submerged beneath the water, it uses an air bubble trapped beneath dense layers of hydrophobic hairs located on its abdomen and legs to cover its entire body, and is then capable of remaining fully submerged for prolonged periods of time. While it may be difficult to believe, these amazing creatures spend pretty much all of their life inside of their air bubble nests, using them as both a home and a transportation device beneath the water. Essentially, these guys are the van life community of the animal kingdom, just underwater. Well, there we have it, the 15 most amazing homes built by animal architects, part 2. What'd you guys think? Let us know your thoughts down below. As always, thanks for sticking around all the way until the end. You've been watching Missing Files. See you next time.